What are your feelings on that?
Oh, we talked to Dean, and we talked to Dean earlier from the phone.
Well, I'm talking to Dean at this moment.
All right.
Dean at this moment, because you're going to be, doing it. I'll have to handle that also. But the point is, what's your advice? You see, the point is, we don't have, I just got to say, just type up a couple, just to have here, which I would only put out, in the event that certain things occurred.
I understand.
But put the, what's your advice?
I think it'd be good that you have a room. And I would think, to be very honest with you, have a leather suit.
Have a leather suit.
Yeah. I was, well, as a matter of fact, they both suggested for themselves. So I've got that. I'm sorry, Steve, I didn't wrong down. So I've already done that with them. Now, I get your advice on that, too. So what I think we want to do, we should have it in two different forms here. We should have it, and I would like to discuss with you the form. It seems to me that the form should be requested at a meeting, and definitely in absence. That would be one thing. The other first would be just a straight resignation.
Mm-hmm.
First, what I would suggest is that you sign both. That's what I have. And then we'll talk about after, because you don't know yet what you're going to put down. If you go in and plead guilty, you never
respond.
If, on the other hand, you're going in on some other basis, then I'm giving them the best proper thing to do.
I would think so.
And that's the way I would discuss it with others, too. If you have any other thoughts, let me know. I'm not going to refresh on things. I just want to be sure John's got the record.
I think it's a good idea. I frankly do.
Yeah.
But I think if you do it for one, I think you have problems with others too, Mr. President.
We already have done that.
All right. That's what I'm trying to advise you.
But on theirs, both the pending the it is all pending their appearance and so forth. This is just yours. Nothing's going to be said. But I've got to have it in hand. You see what I mean? And my reason, as I told them, as a matter of fact, after I talked last night, I told them, I said, I've got to have it in hand so that I can move on this. If, as Pearson, they're reporting me every day. And I said, now Pearson, I said, if you get this stuff confirmed, I'd like you to know. And he said, well, I asked him specifically, I said, what are you going to do? He said, well, who's going to be today? And I don't know, well, Strong's going to be today. There are three today. I don't know who's the third one.
I don't know.
That's right, you're not supposed to be. Then, okay,
what I would like to do is draft up for you an alternative letter. Put it in both options, and you can just put them in the file. Short and sweet.
Fine, fine. I had dictated something myself on my office, which is but you don't have to. If you can give me a better form, fine. But you can do it either way. You or do you want to use a person?
I'd like a professional.
Good. All right, but why don't you take this? Take those and have something that I've got to see Peterson at 1:30.
All right.
I just have
you know, and that's what I wanted to run over with you, read with us, you know, to get your feeling again as to how we handle it, how, you know, you were saying the president should stay one step ahead of this thing. Well, we've got the only problem is what the hell can I say publicly? Now, here's what we've done. I called in, I got in findings. I've been working on them all week, here, actually. I mean, I got the recruiter thing, and I got in findings. And then at 4 o'clock, we got in. So, Peter's findings were true, and signed Peter, and I said, all right, I want to talk to findings and more about this reason. I'm just going to talk to you through here in charge. You follow through, go through, and get to the bottom of this thing, and I will let the chips fall where they may. We covered that all the way down the line. Now, I have to follow him to a certain extent on the prosecution side. On the other hand, on the PR side, I sure as hell am not going to let the Justice Department step out there and say, look, we dragged the White House in here. I've got to step out and do it, John.
That's right. That's right.
But again, I don't walk out and say, look, John, Dean's resignation has been accepted. Jesus Christ, that isn't fair.
Nor would it be fair to say, or when the Republicans have.
Well, you know, I know where we are. Because, you see, they haven't been charged yet. As soon as they're charged for robbery, but in your case, you haven't been charged them yet.
No, I have not.
That's my problem, see, with it. All I want is to have on. The only reason I'm doing this is to, because of you, what you said about someone.
Well, I hope there's a chance today when LaRue goes down that Haldeman, Ehrlichman's name are going to be right down there before the grand jury.
Right, right. The name will be in. But the point is, you don't just throw somebody else because of a name like that.
Of course, I understand.
Well, you could also, if you would, and I would like for you to prepare this a letter that you would have for Ehrlichman and Haldeman. That,
yes, sir.
Then I'll give them the form and let them work on their something that's appropriate. Would you prepare that for me?
Yes, sir.
But they told me last night orally, just as you did, that
they stand ready to cover the record.
They said, well, we'll leave in a minute, we'll leave today, you can do whatever you want. I said, well, no, you're going to have to wait until the evidence, you know what I mean?
Sure.
Which I do agree with.
That's what I did a minute. The question is timing and.
Now let's get the nation's advice as to how we handle this now.
Well, I would say you should have the letters in hand, and then based on what you learned from Peterson, you can make a judgment at the time, and I think you're still 5 steps ahead of what will ever emerge publicly. I don't think
they take it 12 hours. They think very slightly. There's potions, according to the secretary, has got something not on this, but we were talking about everything.
Well, I know some of the things Magruder said. He said that the prosecutors had asked him a number of questions about Ehrlichman and Haldeman. So there's no doubt that's going to be out on the street fast also.
And then the other one will have to. That's my question.
It's unfortunate, and I'm hoping that the ultimate resolution of this thing is that no one has any problem. And that's
legally. That's right, which I hope is your case too. In other words, when I say no, I don't want the White House staff, not you, not Colson, or Haldeman. Because God, that's not true. Let me talk about this point again, because I need to, you know, we know there was no, on the Dean report, Zitter's always said it was our,
that's
right.
Right.
But you remember when you came in, I asked you specific questions, anybody in the White House staff involved, but you told me no.
That's right. And I have no
doubt. You still believe that?
Yes, sir, I do.
Yeah. But you did tell me that in the aftermath, there were serious problems.
That's right,
right. And I said, well, let's see what they are.
Right. And now you're beginning to see what they are. They're potential technical obstruction of justice.
That's right. Not necessarily. Well, I talked to Peterson last night, exactly the same point. He says the obstruction was moral wrong. No, not moral.
Mm-hmm.
He said it may not have been moral wrong. And it may not be legally wrong, but he said from the standpoint of the presidency, you can't have it. That's what he said. So he seems to think that that the obstruction of justice thing is a goddamn hard thing to prove.
That's right.
Prove in court, which I think should be some comfort to you.
Well, my lawyer tells me that, you know, legally, you're in damn good shape.
Is that right?
That's right.
Because of you're not.
That's right.
You were simply helping defendants get their visas in there.
Well,
even what does he say?
In that position, I'm merely a conduit. It's very technical. Very technical. I'm a conduit to other people. That's the problem.
What was the situation, John, in this The only time I ever heard any discussion of the support of the defendants, I must say, I guess I should have assumed somebody was helping them. I must have assumed it. But they were, and I must say, people were good in the way I was busy. It was like you mentioned to me something about the last time you talked about Hunt having a problem.
Well,
that was handled by Mitchell. Is that true, or what the hell is that?
The last time we had a request was
how did it come? Did you have any force?
He didn't do
a dinner or something.
No. O'Brien, who is one of the lawyers that was representing the re-election committee, was asked by Hunt to meet with him. He came to me after the meeting and said that Hunt asked the following message be passed to you. And I said, why me? He said, I asked Hunt the same question.
You mean, or maybe Fred
asked me, Dean.
Oh, okay.
Sure, I've never heard anything like this. And I said,
you never had this from me before?
No.
Let me tell you, what did you report to me on, Phil? It was rather fragmentary, as I recall. You said Fred had a problem.
Very fragmentary.
I said, John, what's going to cost to do this? And that's when I sent you to campus. I said, well, for God's sake, let's see where this thing comes out.
Right.
You said it cost $1 million.
I said, you know, you conceivably could. The way I said, if we don't cut this thing,
anyway, that's the way the conversation goes. How was that handled? We tell him that money.
Well, let me tell you the rest of what Hunt said. He said, you tell Dean that I need $72,000 for my personal expenses, $50,000 for my legal fees. If I don't get it, I'm going to have some things to say about the seamy things I did at the White House for John Ehrlichman. All right, I took that to Ehrlichman. Ehrlichman said, have you talked to Mitchell about it? I said, no, I have not. He said, well, will you talk to Mitchell? I said, yes, I will. I talked to Mitchell. I just passed it along to him. And then there was a meeting down here a few days later in Bob's office with Bob and Ehrlichman and Mitchell and myself. And Ehrlichman said at that time, he said, well, I've got a problem with Hunt straightened out. He said it to me, and I said, well, ask the man who may know, Mitchell. And Mitchell said, I think that problem is solved.
That's all?
That's all he said.
That's good. In other words, that was better than Mitchell now.
That's right.
But you had knowledge of all of that, and caused knowledge of everything.
That's right.
And I suppose I did. I think it's some culpability on that.
I don't think so.
Why not? I try to be talking to myself, so I'm with the other. I must say that I didn't really give it a thought at the time.
No one gave it a thought.
You didn't tell me it was about Ehrlichman, for example. You did that, didn't you?
I know.
You simply said, Hunt needs this money. And you were using it as an example of the problems ahead.
I have tried all along to make sure that anything I passed to you, myself, didn't cause you any personal problems.
John, let me ask you this. Let us suppose that this thing breaks. We ask you, John Dean. John, you were the president's counsel. Do you report things to the president?
What are you reporting? I would refuse to answer any questions of anything.
I think you should. Let me ask you.
Unless you wait,
let me say, on this point, I would not wait. You could say, I reported to the president that the president called me in. I mean, the president authorized me, sir. He called me in. And asked me that before that when the event first occurred, you conducted an investigation and passed to the president the message, no White House personnel according to your investigation involved. You did do that, didn't you?
I did that through Ehrlichman and Halton.
Okay, you did do that.
I'm under oath now that I'm going to have to say I did that through Ehrlichman and Halton.
No, I know you did that. I didn't see you. Remember, I didn't see you until after the election.
That's right.
Which is good. All right. Now, but then you say that then after the election, the president, when the McCord April called you in, I think that's what it was.
After McCord. No, it was before the McCord thing, because you remember he told me after the Friday morning of McCord's letter, he said he predicted this. This was going to happen because I had, in about a week or 2 weeks.
How did I get you in then? What triggered me getting you in?
Well, we just started talking about this thing.
You and Moore together, didn't I?
Well, on a Wednesday morning.
What was the White House involved? It was involved with the damn executive privilege and all that crap.
That's right. The great things were popping. But on the Wednesday morning before, I had.
You mean had three conversations, my recollection?
Well, sorry, I think we have more than that, but of course, we'd have a record of that through
those
people. I think we have more than that. But the one report where I finally, I called Bob.
I agree this on.
Go ahead. Yeah, I called Bob, and I said, Bob, I don't think the president has all the facts.
That's right. And then you came to the Senate this year. That's the first time that I realized that.
That's right.
And, but, and now the White House is going to be money to tell the president before. And your answer there is
no. That was absolutely
correct. That's what last time. See, I don't want you, John, to be in a position. And frankly, I don't want the president to be in a position where one of his trusted people has information that he didn't even check on.
So I just want you to not know.
Fine. You did not know. How did you find out that the last school people? You better, but you can handle that.
I'm sure.
But I did ask you, and I think you should say the president's authorized to say this. I don't reveal a conversation with the president, but he asked me this question. I told him this, that nobody in the White House was involved. And then, in addition to that, to the best of my ability, what do you think you want to handle with the presidential
Well, I think the less said about it, I think that's the difference. I think you say anything you want to say about it.
Right. But I can say, well, let me show you my way to handle that properly. And I just want to be sure that it is the judge's facts. I can say that you did tell me that nobody in the White House was involved. And I can say that you then came in and your request said, I think the president needs to hear more about this case.
That's right.
And it was that time that I started my investigation.
That's right.
Correct.
That was the Wednesday before they were sentenced. Now I can get that data. I don't have it all the time.
But you would be this, and if you have your chronology of that, the Wednesday you came in and told me, that would be helpful for me to have.
That's what I agree.
You see, that's when I became frankly, interested in the case, and I said, I'm going to have it. I want to find out the score. And I set the motion early. Maybe from a few of them, not much of but okay, all right. One other thing, on the privilege thing, I think nothing, so you can be sure that you know, nothing is privilege that involves wrongdoing,
that's correct,
on your part, or wrongdoing on the part of anybody else. I'm telling you that now, and I want you to, when you testify, if you do, to say that the president has told you that. Would you do that?
Yes, sir.
Would you agree to that affirmative? Fine. However, let me say that with regard to what you call the electronic stuff that occurred, and what I have now found is in the leak area, national security area, that I consider privilege.
I do too.
And I think you should say, for example, on that, that what I had is that in the case of the crash of what the FBI did, they were both electronic, and I checked them back. There were some done through private sources. Most of it was done through the Bureau after we got hurt. Hoover didn't want to do crap. What it involved, John, apparently, was this. They were leaving the NSC. They were anti-crack and other bombs. We were trying to plug the leaks.
Right.
And we had that, so we checked it out. Finally, we turned it over to Hoover. Then when Apollo was involved, we just stopped it altogether.
I
can't make the shock is. But in my view, I consider that privilege.
I have no intention of raising that.
Have you informed your lawyers about that?
No.
I think you should not. When I said not because they're hiding anything, except that I do think it's privilege. But it's something up to you.
No, I think it's privilege also.
Support me at home. And this was necessary to do. We had Hoover a little bit, and in the control of the Johnson Center. Now, your guess is when, well, I'm here today, when will you be called? Perhaps Tuesday, Wednesday, or?
I would think sometime this week.
You don't think the thing is likely to break today?
No, I don't. I don't
know, say where's God, he must have these. He seems to have been something's going to go. He didn't let us see me, I'll have to get him later. But, I'll ask Peterson. But don't you agree with me that the president should make the first announcement, not the Justice Department?
Yes, I do.
I mean, that's what they
want to come back.
Hell, I'm going to make the announcement with regard to the group, too. Goddamn, it's our campaign. I'm not going to have the Justice Department.
Oh, actually,
we carry this whole thing. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Don't you agree?
Well, if when
you know,
trigger, when history is written, you'll put the pieces back together, you'll see why it happened. It's because I triggered it. I put everybody's feet to the fire because it just had to stop.
But
and I still continue to feel that.
You put McGruder's feet to the fire.
Yes, I did.
Where did you see McGruder?
I didn't. In fact, I refused to see him. That was one of the problems.
Oh. And that's why.
I talked to him. I met with him in one of these outer offices out here at a meeting.
Why did McGruder talk? I would like to say that Chris.
Because, well.
I was hoping that you would say. You made the statement about just like the elder drawing the wagons up around the wagons. But the primary wells, this we're talking about pre-bridge, was all of the connected, right?
Right. Where it is.
That's right. But on the river,
talk about proceeding along the same course they'd been proceeding to lock in their story, but my story did not fit with their story. And I just told them I refused to change, to alter my testimony, to repeat it just as I knew it. This had to do with the number of meetings in the department.
So that I heard this. Oh, I remember. You told me this, and everybody tells me that. You said, Dean said, I will not go to down there and lie, because you said because of your hand will shake and your emotion. Remember you told me that?
No way, I could. I'm incapable of it.
Thank God. I'm not ever really drunk.
Well,
you tell the truth. That's the thing that you're going to, I told everybody around here, to God damn it, tell the truth. Because all they do is John is compounded.
That's
and
right.
Some of it his would be free today. If he had lied about his espionage, he could have just said, he could just said, look, I knew Chambers, and yes, as a young man, I was involved in Congress activities, but I broke it off many years ago, and Chambers would have drunk.
Well,
if you lie, you go to jail for the lie rather than the crime. So believe me, don't ever lie with these facts.
The truth always emerges.
We know that.
It always does.
Also, there's a question of right and wrong, too.
That's right.
What is right and what is wrong?
That's right.
Well, perhaps there's gray areas, but you're right to get it out.
Sure.
Honestly, I wanted to share that you recall on our conversation. You asked me to do something. I read it with Peterson now. He said he'd handle it. Now that's the proper place. That's where I see. When Libby says he can't talk on tears from higher authority, I am not the higher authority.
No.
It's mentioned.
Well, he said after he's looking for the ultimate.
What do you think he's thinking about?
I think he's thinking about the president. He might say, he has the impression that you and Mitchell probably talk on the telephone daily about this.
You know, we've never talked to him.
I understand that.
Never talked to Mitchell about this. Oh, except about the point whether we go the executive privilege thing.
Right.
He can't answer their question just by the executive session. Except you. Which I think I think you know that about the executive privilege.
I think with presidents, the earlier you're going to fizzle.
Wow.
I think when Peterson finishes this.
You don't think we can hold the executive privilege anyway, do you, John?
Couple of non executive privilege.
Yeah, what's your question?
I think if there are indictments down there in that courtroom, none of the individuals should go up and testify. I think the Watergate is just going to be totally carved out of the urban area.
Yeah, well, that's the Watergate. Then the other stuff is not that important.
Security, that stuff is not that important. They'll probably have a lot of fun with it, but it's not very meaningful.
So you think Libby thought the Bible was only sexual abuse, not the drug money? Well, we covered that last night.
That's right.
There.
That's true at all. I think
that enough?
That's right. Peterson will tell you if it doesn't.
You call me out, but it's enough.
No, I think it's enough.
I'm going to expect you to draw your still in counsel, right? No, Rod, seriously. You've got to divide your team. That's the same with all that are, as long as you're around here. You've got to have it
But I want to lay one thing out. I think there is a mythical belief. I've not talked to Bob or John about this, that they don't have a problem, Mr. President. And I'm really not sure you're convinced they do, but I'm telling you they do.
The problem?
Yeah.
No question about it.
Okay, I just want to.
Yeah. Peterson made the point. I said, tell me what the facts are. He says, the problem is that they're going to get splashed. And he said, when they get splashed, you've got a problem, Mr. President. Now, then he goes on to say, as far as the legal fallout of this concern, he are you here? He said it's a very difficult case to prove. Do you agree with that, Dr. Trump? That's fine. I don't know what word. I mean, I'm speaking on personal terms.
Yeah, but it's a technical case and it's a tough case.
It's a tough case to prove. What do you mean by that? Stuff that mounts up. Oh, you think, for example, the penalty show, that's solely Mitchell. caught up with Benjamin, where he says, I'll do everything I can because as a friend.
And that was with Ehrlich.
Ehrlich
went in Folsom and I got up there and Folsom presented his story. Ehrlich was,
I know,
regarding it. And then John gave Chuck very clear instructions on going back and telling him, you know, give him the inference he's got clemency, but don't give him any commitment.
No commitment.
Right.
That's all right. But first, it's an individual, but there's no commitment. I've got a right to sit here and take a fellow like Hunt or a Cuban whose wife will say something. That's what clemency is about, correct?
For sure.
But John specifically said no commitment. They didn't mean
the
commitment. And Colson then went on to apparently.
I don't know how Colson delivered it in practice.
Church.
Yeah, but I don't know what it is, you know.
So where is this business of the Christmas thing, you know? What the hell was that?
Well, that
must have been Mitchell, huh?
No, that was Chuck again. I think that... I think he said something to the effect that Christmas is the time that clemency generally occurs.
Oh, yeah. Well, that is... I don't think that's going to hurt you.
No.
You. But see, he says one thing, he's a friend of Hunt's. I'm just trying to put the best face on it. It's wrong, and it is, so I've got to know.
Well, one of the things I think you have to be very careful, and this is why Peterson will be very good, is if you take a set of facts and let prosecutors who have no guilt, making no PR judgment on them, but they'll give you the raw facts as they relate to the law, and if later you've got to decide, you know, what public face will be put on those, if they're
going
to come out in court, you know.
You can help on that, John.
Yes, sir. I
know that.
Wherever I may be, I'll be available to help on that.
You want me to say anything
to
about it?
No,
that's not good.
So I think my lawyers and the U.S. Attorney's Office ought to continue to work.
I am having him referred to me daily now.
Right.
Which I think I should do. And so all that I'll say is I'm going to tell him we had a talk today and I went over again the various materials.
What would be the best thing in the world if they decide they've got nothing but technical cases against people at the White House and they chuck them all out? That's not impossible.
Should I call them?
No, sir.
That's what they ought to hear.
That's right.
It'd be a tough case for them to prove, John.
Well, they may decide not to do it, and then none of these things are even released. They're very well.
Well, that's what I want. I understand. The reason I have to have that is in case there's a break tonight. I don't want to have to call John Dean in and say, look, John, can I have it? It looks like I was, what the crack am I doing? I've got to know, because I do have some knowledge that there might be vulnerability. All I'm saying to this, as you know, is that I have heard things from the U.S. Attorney and from John Dean and from my own people that indicate there could be a technical violation, under the circumstances, I feel that it's my duty to have a resignation in hand. Of course, the president always has a resignation.
That's right. But the thing is, the phrasing of the letter is important. You don't cause anybody to follow with a fair trial. So that's why I like to
go there. Well, that's right. I understand. Those are my intentions. I just read it all. Only it's a form for you, and you work it out. And work it out so that it would be one that could apply to you, and then work out an amplitude or an alternate. Just a form that I can get anybody strong.
Is it on your side?
Well, that doesn't come to me, does it?
Well, the whole executive branch is...
No,
it wouldn't
be. No, it wouldn't be. It's to you.
That's right, to you.
Well, I'll get his resignation. I don't think I ought to tell those guys that she's good.
I don't think you ought to tell Strawn, I think.
No. I'll tell Keel. You don't have to do
that. I think Bob ought to do that, though.
Bob Alden?
Mm-hmm.
Good. I'll tell Bob then to get them. That'll be Strawn and Magruder.
All right.
That's your advice. Also, if you do have any random thoughts on how many more that we can do on the presentation of this thing, sit up in your office and think of it. I mean, that's not our handle.
Well, I want to say the president is in front. You know, I want to give you some notes on that I think will help.
Would you do that, sir?
The record, here's what I've done, and what we
think the president